Okay, a recap of the examples we saw earlier, okay? So we were dealing with vertical motion. One motion is we throw something up, right?
Yes.
And we know that if we throw something up, it has to come down eventually, okay?
Yes.
And of course the situation is you could be on the ground, you throw it up, it comes down, or you could be elevated in the beginning, right? Let's say you're on top of a building, you throw something up, it has to come down.
Yes.
All right? Okay? And the other motion problem that we talked about was, let's say we're on top of something, right? Let's say a building, and we just throw it down. Okay?
Yes.
So we noted that for these situations, we just will, we have the equation for S, okay? It's always going to be a half GT squared, right?
Yes.
Plus initial velocity, zero. If there is any, times T,
plus
the initial S position,
zero.
S sub zero, okay?
Yes.
So for the first one, let's say for this one, where you were right at the ground, okay? The equation for motion here will be S is equal to 1/2 GT squared. G will be negative, okay? Always is the convention, right?
Yes.
So G is either negative 32 feet per second squared, okay?
Yes.
Or if you're doing metric system, then it's negative 9.8, did I do it right? Meters per second
per
squared?
Second squared, yes.
Okay? So you plug the G in here, all right? Plus whatever initial velocity you impart. And now here, because you're on the ground, right, S is zero, so there's no S,
yes.
Okay? So you're done here.
Yes.
Is that correct?
Yes.
Now, if you're throwing it up first before it goes down, right, this is what we need to point out. What is the V sub zero here? What sign will V sub zero have if you're throwing it up first before it goes down? V sub zero has to be?
Positive.
Positive, right?
Yes.
Correct?
Yes.
Because you're going up,
positive.
And then go
yes.
down, okay? So then this next situation, sorry, it's so crowded, okay? The equation of motion here will be what? It's half GT squared, right?
Yes.
Okay? Plus V sub zero T, but because you're up here in the beginning, right, you have an initial position. S sub zero, okay?
Mm-hmm.
And again, because you threw it up first before you went down, this V sub zero piece has to be a positive,
positive.
Number. Okay?
Yes.
That's what we did with the first example that we did earlier with the balls,
yes.
Right? We assumed that we had to impart a positive velocity for the balls to go up first before they go down.
They go down.
Correct?
Yes.
Okay. Now for the second problem where we had a stone, right?
Yes.
Just falling. So we ended up with the equation S equals 1/2 GT squared, right?
Yes.
Always, right? Plus V sub zero T. Plus S sub zero, okay? We need an initial position because the position S is always measured from the ground, right? So there's always the initial position, which is the height, all right? This is a mainstay. Half GT squared would be a negative quantity, right?
Yes.
Because G is always going to be negative.
Yes.
Now this, because we throw it downwards following the convention, so you go down.
So V zero is
the
negative.
V sub zero here has to be a
negative number.
Okay?
Yes.
Does that summarize everything that we did?
Exactly.
All right?
Yes.
So for vertical motion, I guess, up is always positive and down is negative.
Negative.
And that's all, you only have to worry about that for the velocity.
Velocity.
The velocity piece.
Oh, okay.
Because G is a scalar, right?
Yes.
Acceleration due to gravity, we just do the scalar. And
yes.
We just follow it's negative because acceleration always will tend to pull you down.
Exactly.
Okay?
Okay.
I'm not a physics major, but I guess that's